man, I always see these music videos, right, with loads of ladies, and I'm never in there. I need to find, you know, my artists, my brothers and sisters, to be in the music videos, to have a good time. I could hold the lights, I've said this countless times. Hold the lights, work on the sound, do something just to be around the ladies. But anyways, I'm glad I'm here with you guys tuning in today. Everyone who makes time to join us, very, very happy to be here, of course, because we get to talk to you, basically. And everything I always say, we talk about stuff you want to see, from the conversations to the artists that are here to the events we're a part of, every single thing. Now, I have Raskuku, he's going to be here in a bit. I have Silverbread in the house. We're going to be talking to them about their lineup and everything. But of course, when it comes to staying interactive, please send us messages. MX24TV, the hashtag's MXLive. Be a part of the conversation. Tell the artists I want to be in the music videos when the ladies are around. Please, let's send them a DM and be a part of it. But as we do every single weekday, whenever I'm here, we're going to go for a quick commercial break. Then we're going to get back. Interesting conversation, I promise you, because he has a new project he's promoting. And yes, okay, so I'm your host, Jason LA. Sit back, relax, enjoy. We'll be right back. I never get used to the fact that, you know, I get to watch these music videos, see the artists perform them, the stages they're on, the songs they constantly release, and then get to talk to them. Raskuku.
Bless you.
Bro, I'm very happy you're here, man.
Yes,
I told you. You see, as soon as you came here, right, everybody was like, oh, Ras.
Yeah.
Right, they were talking like, oh, man, we're so happy to see you. The way I never get used to the fact that, you know, I get to talk to guys like you who make the music that inspires. Have you gotten used to the attention at this stage in your career? Because it's happened like over and over and over.
So we are cool with it. I'm always cool with it, you know.
How do you stay that cool, man?
Because we've been through a lot. And when it comes to this kind of thing, we've been through it. So
okay. Once again, thank you so much.
You can meet some people. Mm-hmm. They will just lie down for you to work on them.
Even when
you beg them for them to wake up, they don't.
They won't, right?
Yeah, so
they won't. They won't. Okay, as I was saying, thank you so much for making time.
Yeah, man.
Because I know you're very busy. You actually have a new project that you've dropped.
Yes, sir.
So we're going to get into all of that. But Ras, a bit of context. How many years have you been doing this for?
The music thing?
Yeah.
After I stopped the football. Okay, from school.
From school? That's like for years.
Yeah, for
2 years. And you just said football.
Yeah.
Was that the thing?
I wasn't born a musician. I was born a footballer.
Oh.
Yeah, so it is due to one or two things. That is why I stopped playing.
So if you could change the journey, if you had the power at this moment, right?
With the age?
No, I mean to start over again.
Again, I'll play football.
For real?
Yeah.
You know your fans won't be happy you're saying this.
Oh, they'll be happy. They'll be happy seeing me playing the football.
Oh, man. What was your position?
Number 9, 7, 11.
Or 9, 7, and 11.
Yeah.
Those are tough positions, you
know? Yeah, I'm a tough guy, you know.
I mean, okay, right? Okay, another one. What team do you support?
In Ghana, the biggest club, you don't know.
Rasky, you're going to get in trouble for this.
Oh, no.
Because you're going to mention one club and it's going to... So what's the biggest club?
There are a lot of clubs here. They are all doing good. But it seems my team now, they are not doing good.
What team is that?
The House of Hook.
Oh, okay. Yeah. So that's the biggest club in Ghana.
Oh, we won the first Confederation Cup, you know.
Okay.
So me, myself, you know, I live at Domi.
Yeah.
So as they were bringing the cup, I met them at St. John's.
For real?
Yeah, 2004.
Wow.
Yeah.
Okay. What about internationally? What's
internationally, still House of Hook.
Like that. Those are going to say Chelsea or Real Madrid or something like that.
Who are they?
I like that. It's good I didn't mention my club because I would have been heard. He said that. But anyways, once again.
You know when House of Hook was House of Hook, there was no Chelsea. Go check it out. You go just read about House of Hook or Asante.
That one I'll not disagree because I'm not a Chelsea fan. So, I mean, obviously.
Oh, what fan are you?
Yeah.
What fan are you?
My team is struggling a little bit. You might just say You saw that coming.
I was there, I just moved.
Oh, man. No, please come back. We need you. But anyways, the thing is, even though it didn't go the way you wanted it to go, music has been a blessing to you.
True.
Was it always on the sidelines when we were playing soccer? Or was it when whatever happened and you were just like, okay, let me just try this?
No,
How did that transition? I never thought
of doing music until Obrafo came out with Paimuka.
Oh.
Yeah, so I got the inspiration from the album Paimuka.
Okay.
I went on to buy his execution diary and then Sounds of Our Time coming from Hammer.
Okay.
So Obrafo gave me the inspiration to do music. And oh. I can tell you that in between 20 years, in between those years from, we are in, 2014, from 2001 or 2000 up to now, those doing music right now, the young boys, not the young ones, like those after 30 years to 40, in between 30 to 40, most of them, 80 to 90% got their inspiration from Obrafo.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, that's fact.
It's a fact.
Yeah, that's fact.
Yeah.
Have you told him this personally? Have you had that?
Governor Dakun, me and Governor Dakun never met. But, you know, I am in Domi. He lives at Taifa.
Yes.
So it's a one constituency.
Oh, man. But that's cool. Yeah. I like the way, you know, as big as you are, you're acknowledging, you know, the people who inspired you.
Yeah.
As you were saying, young boys, do you think we acknowledge, or the young boys now acknowledge those before them, like the way you
do? Some of them do. You know, when it gets to some places, not all the people like applaud you.
Yeah.
Some will say other things, but you can see most of them come out and say, like Stonebwoy like this, he always makes sure he tells the people that at least something helped him.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Onye, like on fact, like Onye no one say who yeah that. Yeah. So we got so many people like that who always make sure that they let the people know who brought them into the limelight.
Okay. I like that. Very important to, you know, again acknowledge, you know, and appreciate those who inspired us. Why reggae dancehall? Okay, so first, you make dancehall music? Do you make reggae music? Do you make reggae dancehall music?
Okay, Jason, before the people got to know Rascal, I was doing rap, I was doing other things, but the name Rascal, or the brand Rascal, is a reggae brand.
Oh.
So the song people got to know of Rascal was Adiebechi. So it was a reggae song, and I made sure at that time I released a reggae album. Yeah, it has so many songs on it.
Okay.
And that song made me who I am today as Rascal.
Okay, so you're a reggae artist.
I'm a reggae artist, but when the rhythms come, I bust.
Oh, even you can,
you can wake up right now and give me boom, boom. I'll give you something.
I mean, yeah, we've seen him perform, so we know he does that.
So when the rhythms come, songs like Jaja was here, the one just played. It's not a reggae song.
Yeah.
Neither is it a dancehall song.
Yeah.
But still, I mash it up.
Okay.
When you check Pagum style, oh baby, I'm here, no Pagum style, you get to know it's not a reggae song. I was able to deliver on it, showing that when it comes to rhythms, Rascal is a top notch. I just make sure I kill the rhythm.
Okay.
Bury it.
Okay. What do you think about the state of reggae music right now in Ghana, from Ghana? Because reggae music is always going to be reggae music, right?
Yes.
So whenever I ask this question, I want to be like very specific on, I mean, from us. Because Bob Marley is forever going to be Bob Marley, right? The people who did it before us are always going to be them.
Yeah.
But coming from here, what do you think about the state of reggae dancehall music right now?
Yeah, it's booming. As you can see, you can make mention of a lot of reggae dancehall artists in Ghana who are making it big. If you should call 10 artists in Ghana, I think you get about 5 reggae dance or some artists in there.
Yeah.
And so that shows that we are doing well. And when most of them are on the dancehall side.
Yeah.
And we've taken the reggae side so that we can all move the culture forward.
Okay.
Yeah, it is not a bad idea for them to just push only dancehall.
Okay.
It is good.
Okay.
But reggae and dancehall be one culture, it be one thing. Reggae brought out dancehall. So when they hold that side, they also hold the reggae.
Okay.
And we got so many people holding the reggae.
Yeah. Because, you know, there was a time it was crazy. I think 3-4 years ago, it was non-stop back-to-back. And I think when it comes to genres of music, that happens. I mean, there was a time it was jazz. You know, the time was R&B. We always like Usher and things. It was, as you're saying, Obrafo, Redrock Stone, Paimuka and all those. So people now say, oh, maybe he deserves more, man. We want to see more artists. What do you think? How do you feel when you hear these things?
The thing is, the reggae, you see, reggae is not a genre that waits for people to come and then do something before it gets there. Reggae is always there.
Okay.
You see, the only thing the reggae artists need is the puduo. When I say puduo, is the money. Because you need to invest and then promote your stuff. If you don't promote it, you do not get there. So the problem isn't anything but money. Because when you get the money, you can invest, you put your songs wherever, you pay for the songs to go. If you don't pay, your songs will be in your pocket.
Oh.
Yes.
You know, a lot of people don't even believe this.
No, you have to pay. Okay, for you to play somebody's video here, is it the person who built the station?
So you think it's fair?
It's fair for you to come and pay and then get your stuff published. That is how it is. If you don't pay, I remember there was one TV station. I went there. Mm-hmm. I paid. But they had a free, like, option too. When you get there, they tell you, okay, this is free. You pay, you start playing it from today. But when you don't pay and it is free, you put it here. When they are there, they'll be okay. Just put it inside and play for you. No, we don't want it that way.
Yeah.
You see, you pay, you take your receipt and you go.
Okay.
For them to work on, it is okay. Somebody's work. The studio isn't for me. Neither is this yours. It's somebody okay. Who has built it. Employ somebody.
Yeah. People. Because you know, some artists watching might say, oh, Ras, we don't have the money. Like, it's difficult.
Yeah, yeah.
So that's to compete problem. On the international market.
That is a problem. That is a problem. NABBR is money. And when you get the money, you can, you know, this playlist pitching, this YouTube, this, because the people are watching the numbers.
Mm-hmm.
And so if reggae doesn't get that number,
it won't go. You make the good music, but
it won't go anywhere.
Oh, man. Yeah. So basically, that's the biggest problem facing
the financial problem.
How have you overcome it? Because you're still doing it.
Yeah,
your music is still. Is it a blessing? Is Razkuku got some money somewhere? Because I'm going to give my momo number right now. I'm wasting no time, man. Like,
you so have to give them.
Yeah.
The thing is, Razkuku is a big brand. And then I've been doing this music from way back. I got so many soldiers behind me. Me, myself, I didn't just come and do music. We made sure that we built soldiers behind us who can help push the brand. It's not me alone. We're doing it together.
Mm.
Yeah. So if the money isn't from Razkuku, it'll be coming from the crew.
So you built it from the streets, like the people. You started with the people.
Oh. That's so many people, giants behind Razkuku.
Yeah.
Yeah. So if I should come out with, that is how you do it. See people, because if you don't move, the thing will never come to you.
Mm. Okay.
Yeah, that's why you say if the mountain doesn't come, Muhammad will go to the mountain. Because the mountain can never move and come to you. If you need something on the mountain, go there.
Okay, so let me flip this. Do we, the artists, need to do more in terms of chasing that mountain? Because again, the conversations always come about competing with this market. I mean, you've heard it. Oh, Nigeria is doing this. South Africa is doing this. Right. Oh, our artists are not doing enough. Oh, we're not traveling. We're not shooting these kind of music videos. So do the artists need to do more?
The artists, when it comes to performance, traveling, everything, they all can do it too.
Mm-hmm.
Aside laziness. Some people to the money will be there, but they're lazy.
For real?
Yeah. For them to go to interviews, it'll be a problem.
And you've witnessed this?
Oh, a lot. So me, I don't joke with my interviews. When you call me, if I can't come, I'll let you know I can't.
Okay.
Yeah, if I can, I'll make sure I come. If I don't come, I'll talk to you. We fix another day.
Okay.
Yeah, because you need me, I need you.
Yes, 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 definitely, definitely. I can't do this without you.
Yeah.
Definitely. Wow, that's... You know, you hear these things, right? People talk about it. But when it comes from someone like you, right, who's been doing this for years, who observes, who's seen different generations of artists, and we're always talking about artists, and we hear things that we overlook, like sometimes it's just a little laziness. You know,
yeah.
We need to push a bit more.
Laziness will never take you anywhere. You know, you'll be there, the money will be there, but somebody too will be there, have the money, and the person will blow.
Mm.
You'll be thinking, why am I not blowing? Or some of them, when they get the money now, they feel pompous. Even taking somebody's money, just a video self, a very problem for a show. So a lot of things. But when it comes to promotion, it's about money.
Yeah.
And the artist, when you get the product, don't sit at home. Look for people. Go to people. If the person doesn't come to go, talk to people. They will help you.
Mm.
Yeah.
Ah, that's interesting coming from, again, this is not a small guy, you know, but this is very interesting coming from me. And thank you for adding your voice because we always have to learn. And again, I feel like these are little things that we overlook. Like, oh, if I have the money and I sit at home, it's still going to work out. But you have to go out there. You have to do these things.
Some artists will come here and tell you, oh, artists, don't pay payola. Don't pay payola. If you pay payola, they will chop your money. No.
So you think payola is good?
Pay. What is payola?
Pay.
That's the name. Pay. Because of the name, people see it to be wrong. Pay. Because you are paying for your, like, your works to be shown to the world. And so you want your work to be shown to the world without paying. Who is going to, who should bath from the house, pick car and come and sit in the studio and then for you to just go to the studio and come and say, let's promote your song.
Wow, that's interesting.
Yes. That is why those with the big money are doing most of the things.
They are paying.
Yes.
Wow. Okay, Ras, how do you feel when, you know, with everything you're doing, right, some fans might say, I feel like Ras Kuku deserves more Because I feel like this question is twofold, right? You can look at it like, oh yeah, my fans support me, they deserve more. And also someone might say, nah, you're not appreciating what I'm doing enough. When someone says that to you, how do you feel?
My fans, they're really and truly, they want me to do more.
They want you to do more?
Yeah.
Okay.
Because they need a lot of things from me, okay. Especially. I should make sure I give them the songs, promote it well for it to get to wherever I need to go. If I don't do that, they'll get bored.
Mm.
They look up to you.
Yeah.
They want you to win awards so that they can also boast when they sit down, when they are talking about artists. They, oh, me too, my artist did this. So if you don't do that, nah. And me, their fans have appreciated me a lot.
Mm.
I cannot say they haven't. Mm. They have. And what I have to give to them, I think I haven't done all. I need to push in more for them to enjoy what I have.
Okay, so you feel like with everything you've done,
yeah,
there is more to do.
More than more.
More than more,
yeah.
Right? Okay, and that's why we're going to talk about the project that you have coming up, yeah. Which is Making Waves. Everybody's talking about it. When you look back at winning the 2020
VGMA,
how does that make you feel? Like, are you like, yeah, I did that? Or is Rascuku like, it's past and gone, let's move on to the next?
No, I did that. Yeah. I did that because
I like that.
It isn't easy.
It's not.
Yeah, for look at the number of artists we have,
yes,
in Ghana, and then for you to be chosen as the winner. And checking that category, the first person who won that was Stoneboy. And I was the second person to win that, and episode won it. So the Reggae Dancehall Artist of the Year, only 3 people have it.
Yeah, that's deep.
Yes.
Wow.
It's a fact.
A lot of people, I'm sure, haven't paid attention
to it. Yeah, Reggae Dancehall Artist of the Year.
And you're part of that thing.
Yeah, was introduced in 2015. And Stoneboy won that. 16, he won. 17, he won. 18, he won. So the 19th, where that thing happened, which in tell for me, I won.
How do you feel when people disregard the fact that that thing happened? That is why Rascuku won it. Did you get annoyed?
They are jokers. They are jokers. They don't know what to do. They don't have any plan. When you talk about doing, they say, Rascuku, this.
Right.
Okay, so but what about the award that they won? Is it because Lumba wasn't there? Or Kujentry wasn't there? So I don't listen to those things.
Okay.
Just move on. But we were happy we won that because it's part of the history. You can't take it away.
Yes, you can never take that away. Fast forward, Stoneboy wins it and he acknowledges you.
Yes.
How does that make you feel?
Yeah, he's a brother. Stoneboy is a brother. And before he won the Artist of the Year, I told Ghanaians that Stoneboy is going to win the award because before...
Wow.
Yeah, before that, the works he did was so...
Yeah. Right, I.
Yeah, so before the awards, he had done a lot of works,
yeah,
both Ghana and outside Ghana. So both local and international.
Mm.
So he needed to win that. And
a lot of people might actually say, why is Rascuku bigging up his competition like this? You know?
No.
The
year I won the Reggae Dancehall Artist of the Year, Samini told Ghanaians that I deserve it because I worked hard.
Oh, man.
So
that's nice.
We, the Reggae Dancehall Artists, we are one. Just that the Reggae Dancehall Jenna is hot.
Oh.
But we are one if they don't know.
Wait, you need to, like, really go more on this because that's the thing, right? I feel like people, when it comes to Reggae Dancehall, right, the culture and the lifestyle is very heavily attached to the music.
Yes.
So, like, you're living your music.
Yes.
Right? So when people feel like, or they hear the music and it's like, oh, I'm going at you. Reggae is very hard, right? Yeah. They feel like the lifestyle, that means Rascuku doesn't get along with Stoneboy. Rascuku doesn't talk to Samini. Rascuku's probably beefing with this guy.
No.
But that's not the case, though.
No, I'm cool with all of them, from Wale, Stoneboy, Jupiter.
Or maybe you're just a nice guy.
No, they're also nice. Just that is a hot Jenna.
Okay.
And when it comes to the work, yeah, we go jack up.
Okay, back, okay, I like
come
that.
Back, yeah.
I like
when
that.
Hey, imagine you are competing with somebody and they say, okay, who is going to win? Are you going to say the person?
No,
you say you. Even if I'm competing with Michael Jackson, I'll let them know I'll win him.
Mm.
Yeah.
But you see, that's what you did and you bigged up. That's why I think you're a really nice guy. Yeah, I feel like Rascuku is like a really positive guy. Like, I don't know, because I was telling my brother, right, he's sitting here, and I told him that I've always wanted to meet you because I see you in your music videos, like, you're very bubbly.
Yeah.
But when it comes to the music, it's like there's the energy and it's funny, like, Charlie, when I see Rascuku, who am I going to meet?
No, I'm cool, right? I'm cool.
Oh,
myself, I'm cool. I don't like talking too much. So, but when I bring out...
The fire is...
Boom.
The fire will be firing. So that's you on stage.
Yeah, that's me, Stoneboy, episode.
Yeah, Stoneboy's talking,
episode.
This is nice
Stoneboy
to see, man.
Yeah, man, it's one family. when you check we the reggae dancehall artists, we are one. Yeah, that's why I told you that the genre is hot. So when you follow the hotness of the genre, you think that we are bad people.
Oh. Ah, that's interesting. Yeah. I really like the fact that you added your voice to this. Okay, so now this happens, right? You've won all these awards. The acknowledgement is happening. Your fans are very happy, obviously, with what you're doing. How do you top all this, right? After a successful past 4 or 5 years, right? Now in 2024, we're going to talk about the project moving forward. What does Raskuku do next? Do you think about these things?
A lot. I have so many things to do. The Raskuku Foundation is coming up.
Oh.
Yeah.
Please, what's that about? Kindly enlighten us.
Okay, you know, Raskuku is the ghetto president. And so I have to make sure that everything or anything around me is positive. So I want to start the Raskuku Foundation from the girls, those girls who are in their menstruation period.
Okay.
So we share pads.
Sanitary pads. Okay. Educating them on how to take care of themselves and all of that. Okay, cool.
The Raskuku thing also will be working on footballers. Raskuku Foundation.
Well, I think like you'd be a really cool agent, man. You never know, right?
The Raskuku Foundation will be working on artists too.
Oh man. Okay, that encompasses everything.
Yeah, because we need to let everybody be okay.
Okay.
Yeah, everybody has to be okay.
Okay.
Yeah, so when you're a footballer and we see you are good, we just bring you on board and then we check and see. So everything is in process. Very soon to be out.
Let me just say this. Right? I'm imagining your artist wins the Champions League and they're playing Bo at the stadium. That's going to be crazy.
Yeah, and that when we win that Champions League trophy,
it will be
more than the VGM. We go walk through Africa and Europe everywhere. We go make them know, say, we walk from here, go.
Ras, with that, how do you feel also when people are like, oh, Raskuku, too much energy, man. He was too excited about the little things.
Things like the way I won the award.
Yeah, you won the award, you're happy walking around.
The people I showed the award to, they've never seen the award before.
True.
So they were happy seeing it. Maybe those people laughing or those people saying a lot of things, they wish they could touch it. So how does it look? How does it feel?
Yeah.
I want to see it. Raskuku could bring it. When they tell you Raskuku could bring it, am I going to clip it? I need to... No. Take it to
inspiring the next,
yes,
right,
for them to see that this is how the thing looks like. The music that I have gone to the studio, recorded it, short video, my own music. Mm-hmm. Then I bring it to your people. That my people listen to it. When they listen to it, I get the money.
Yeah.
When I get something out of that, I need to show it back to them.
Yeah.
Like, this is how the thing looks like. This is the award. Whatever we did, this is the outcome of it.
Yeah. No matter the ridicule, the laughter. Yeah, I like that.
People win Champions League, they sleep on next day.
Yeah,
even
right.
Even though they've won the World Cup.
Yeah. Yeah. I like that. Looking at how positive you are and appreciative you are for your fans and your music, and the current state of the Ghana music industry, if you could change anything, what would you change? Because again, you're talking about the next generation of artists, your fellow dancehall artists. Would you change something if you could?
What can I change? There's nothing you can change. There's nothing. Because the industry is built with people's mind. And so everybody has to do what is good.
Are they good minds at the moment?
Yeah, in everything you have bad and good.
But if we had more good, right?
If they say where God himself, they prepare his MPC, or when some went there to prepare his kumi. Yeah, so wherever we have good.
Light and darkness, yes. Right?
Yeah. So we'll all be inside the industry, but definitely the good ones will pop up.
I like that. Yeah. I like your take on life, man. I'm learning a lot today.
Because you cannot change the people's mind, but you see it, and then when they listen, we just take out some one, two that are not needed. You can't change everything.
You can't change everything. The good thing about all this is that it reflects in your music.
Yeah.
You're very honest in your music, right? And this year, you've dropped a project, an album.
Root of Evil.
Very interesting title coming from a very positive guy. So let's talk about the title, Road of Evil.
Yeah.
Please explain this title to me. And And the cover is very deep.
Just Sam.
Right? Please explain this to me, right?
All
right,
so when you check, you get to know that, okay, Rudolph Hill, Rascal Cookies on top. So open your arms. Somebody is standing there looking up to Rascal.
Yeah.
Okay, so I would say the person is praying that the Most High delivers him from the road of evil.
Oh.
So we got two ways. We got good way and bad way. We all hope you walk on the good way. But sometimes when you flip and then you go there, you pray that the Most High guides and protects.
Because I feel like everybody's life, you will...
There's no straight road. Definitely. Okay. You stumble. And when you stumble, you have to know that the Most High is with you.
Oh. So, Jah make we live, Jah make we good people. Jah take we out from the road of evil. Never make we sad, never make we fumble. On our way to Zion, so we conquer evil. You know, a lot of people have difficulty in believing your voice is actually that. People feel like you worked on your voice in your music.
No.
But that's actually your voice.
Me, I don't depend on auto-tunes like some people.
Hey, Charlie, yes. Yes.
No, the voice was given, it's a blessing.
Yeah. I get that. So, okay, 10 songs.
Yeah, 10 songs.
Are there any features on there?
One.
Okay, who did you feature, please?
Akwesi Amewuga.
Oh, I spoke to him, I think, like a few months ago.
Yeah.
Really interesting guy, man. He's doing big things. Why did you decide to feature only him?
Yeah, because at the moment, he's the only one doing rap. All the rappers are singing.
What do you think about that?
It's a good way. It's a good move. Because a comedy will rap, you know? So it's a enye hota.
So what if next week Amewuga starts singing?
No, he'll not start singing because you're hot. Okay. Sarkodie is a hot rapper.
Okay, that's why he's still like rapping like that. Okay. So the other rappers are... Okay, so you featured him on there. The only feature, when you drop a project like this, right, do you get calls from your fellow artists, oh, Ras, why not do your album top? Like, bro, the way me and you did, like, do people reach out
to you? You know, go feed day top. If you call me, I will tell you straight. Charlie, I hear you.
Ras, why?
Because they're human to me. You know, they reach me.
So that's why, okay.
Yeah.
Okay, I'm sure some of them will be happy about it.
They are always happy because when I call them, they also tell me.
Okay, what's your favorite song on there?
My favorite song, I think, Road of Evil. My favorite song. Track 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10.
All of them?
Yes.
Basically?
Yes.
Okay. I like this title. It's called Mie Reggae, right?
Mie Reggae.
Please tell me about it.
None of them can take me crown. Mie Reggae, Mie Reggae.
Okay.
Send me Gine Mua Babylon Frank. Oh. I'm going to say Rascal Kuya Vibe Yen. Say Yechia Eya Guide Yen. Onyum bako eye ye de pani show them low into ni kojo crunchy eya guide ye hwe enyum ni ni o rege nyame no mi amini o ghetto you send me vibes more than to oma crown me long time one more friend me ghetto you presido.
When it comes to reggae dancehall and this crown thing, is that how the culture is like? Does it always have to be the one?
Yeah, you have to be you. You have to know that you are a king. So you leave yourself and be calling other artists, okay, no.
Okay, but it seems very like prevalent in reggae dance, like I'm the one. Like,
yeah, because we are all lions and every lion is a king.
Okay.
Yeah, and the fans also decide who is this, who is this.
So it doesn't necessarily mean there's beef or like I'm better than you.
WWE, I'm the ghetto president. If you think you are, you also find your
you also find your How's the response been to the album, man?
Great.
Crazy, massive, right?
Excellent.
I like that.
Yeah.
I like that. Bro, I'm very like inspired, you know, by who
just,
you are and the fact that you live your music and you know, I'm sure you know you inspire a lot of people. Before you leave today, what do you want to tell, you know, your fans and the ghetto youth, man?
Yeah, man. So what I have to say is love Jah, work hard and make money is the motto of poor music. Love Jah, work hard and make money. Make sure you follow Rascal Crew everywhere because I've got something big for you. Something, and when it comes to music, we know already. We're not a joke. Yeah, man. So, and to the ghetto youth, yeah, I want to say it's an election year. You make sure that you don't sit idle and make somebody come and tell you, I give a fuck if you will be 3 months on the way. Do something. Because the politicians who own Otu Abani will be Pawaira. So make sure Ghana is at peace. Because we don't need peace. You don't want peace. We have the peace already. Let's protect it. Yeah.
Oh man, thank you so much. Love Jah.
Work hard
and make money. I agree with all of it. 100%. 100%. Thank you so much. So we're ending the Road of Evil. Please, this is your home. Come through anytime. I appreciate this conversation. Yes, I hope I get seen some.
You must have yes.
Bless
him.
I do have to let him go. But as he said, enjoy his music. It's on all platforms.
Everywhere.
Find it, buy the music, please. That's the best way, the number one way I've always said, to support the artists. Go to their concerts, you know, share the music. Tell someone to tell somebody else. I have to let him go. Enjoy this. We'll be right back.
Oh. Charlie.